Hello and good afternoon. Merry Christmas to the two of you.
Hi, guys. Thank you.
Who's this?
Wow. What an amazing project that you guys have put together here. Because, I mean, first of all, Jingle Bell Rock, you guys have put your own spin on it that makes it, it's so refreshing to hear.
Thank you. I'm really proud of it. I have to give David pretty much all the credit because I was just literally one of the many musicians on that's how I think of it. Like, just even though I'm not a really musician, but you told me what to do. So I just listened, and I don't maybe always listen to him as his wife, but as a singer, I pretty much give him full control.
Well, to be in that studio, yeah, that's nice, because when you're in that studio, I mean, all of a sudden it's like you're wearing the artistic colorizing and things like that. In other words, you're expressing in different ways because you know it's going to reach us out here.
Right.
Yep, that's right. And we had a great time recording this album, and we look forward to doing some more songs next year to add to it. So we're sort of doing half and half this year and next year. And it was just fun.
The really cool thing is you guys are going to take this out on the road. I mean, you're going to be, you know, live performances. You're going to be on the Today Show. That's got to be exciting too.
Yeah. That'll be fun.
Yeah. It's a little nerve wracking. And it's a little, you know, doing all the traveling. We're touring. We're doing about 12 dates between now and Christmas, including Vegas on December 16th and 17th.
You know, it's funny. I was just thinking that when we're making the album, there's more pressure on you. But when we're promoting the album, there's more pressure on me.
Yeah, all I got to do is play the piano. I don't have to sing at 6 o'clock in the morning on the Today Show.
Will this become a family tradition in the way that each year the tour will go into other areas of the country and things like that?
I hope so. Sure. I mean, we have yet to see what a Christmas tour feels and looks like, but we're about to find out. And if it goes well, I don't see why we wouldn't. I've been talking about doing a Christmas tour for 20 years, so here it is. So we'll make the best of it.
Well, this collection of music includes, you know, I mean, Rudolph and Blue Christmas. There's so many. What was it like to step into the moment of Christmas? Because I try to celebrate it every day.
You do?
I do. Wow. I do.
All right.
I mean, I had that heart attack at 47, and then from that day forward, every day is Christmas.
Wow. Oh, and, wow. Geez, that's amazing. Well, I like that attitude. We just, you know, sit around the piano and find songs that we like and start jamming on them. And then those are the songs that basically, you know, became the record. And we can't wait to do that process again next year to find five or six more.
When you step into it, usually when Christmas music is recorded, it's usually like in the summer months. Did you have to kind of cool down the air conditioning and things like that just to get into the spirit of it all?
No, well, we were actually in Malibu at his engineer's home. So in the summer, it's actually quite most days. It's pretty, you get that sort of beach breeze, and we had a really nice view from the engineer's house. So no, it was great. We didn't have any heat waves.
And, you know, making music is making music, whether it's Christmas or Broadway or top 40 or whatever. It's just making music. Same principles apply. And I think the one thing you'll notice about this album, that Kat is smiling throughout all the songs. She loves Christmas. And I think it shows on these songs. So if there was a Christmas spirit, it was from her smiling throughout the songs.
Thank you.
Catherine, do you find that maybe in the future you can bring your acting right into it as well and turn it into an onstage performance of where you share the story and the music becomes a part of it?
You know, it's funny that you say that, because it's something that I've been thinking about. Our vision for this Christmas album started kind of small, and it's gotten bigger and bigger. And so our idea for this year is to release half of the album, and then next year the second half. And we have plans, we'll see if it comes to fruition, but of putting like a little Christmas special together. And so I've had some visualization of what we could do on stage and all the things we can incorporate. So I don't think you're too far off.
Wow. Where can people go to get the full tour that you guys are doing this year and to find out more about everything when it comes to the Christmas music?
DavidFoster.com. I think he has his own website. You can see a bunch of our dates, but also I think if you just Google it, it'll come up. We have quite
our dates are all on the East Coast in December.
In December, and then two in Las Vegas. But no, we're in Las Vegas at the Wynn's 17th and or 16th and 17th.
We should have that list in front of us right now to help you, but we don't. We don't have it.
I can tell him all the dates. I have it on my phone.
Oh, you do? Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, we're playing East Coast. So if you're on the East Coast,
we're in Medford, Massachusetts. We're in, you know,
Morristown, New Jersey.
All these great
places. Oh, we're at the Parks Casino in Pennsylvania, yes, which is a great venue.
We're in Providence, Rhode Island. I mean, I got it all. Stony Brook, New York. We're touring around.
Beautiful, beautiful. Well, congratulations, and once again, Merry Christmas, you two. Please come back to this show anytime in the future.
Thanks for having us.
You bet. You be brilliant today, you two.
Merry Christmas. Thank you.